Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And I'm Matti.
And Matti is Mr. Heat Pump of Finland.
Yes.
And today we are going to do heat pump video. And this is the stupid video that I was promising on last heat pump video. So the idea is to install that heat pump to this car. And we are doing it because the summer is coming. And I'm already like missing the winter. It's already too hot and I want good winter driving experience. So Matti from Lämpöykkön is going to help us. And Matti is also representing Toshiba today.
Yes, Tuomas was coming from Toshiba, but he was very busy because of the cooling pumps.
Yeah, the last summer was really hot on Finland and everybody wants now heat pump to their house.
Yeah.
But the idea is pretty simple. We are going to install really large heat pump to really small car. And it should cool down the car to like sub-zero temperatures. And I think there isn't much else to do than just install the heat pump and see how it goes. Yes, and we are installing the heat pump now, and we are going to do this bit differently than usual because we want to get the inside of the car really cool. I would like to get it below zero, and usually you don't cool down your house so much, but it can be so-called outside. And the outside unit is designed to work on really cold temperatures, on like winter and stuff like that. So we are going to put outside unit in and inside unit out. And then we just put the heat pump on heating mode and it tries to heat up the outside. And to heat the outside air, it pulls the heat from inside car and dumps it out. So we can get the car much colder this way. And also if the outside unit freezes, it starts to build ice. There is de-ice mode on that, so it can solve that also. And yeah, I made this pretty professional frame for the inside unit. And the outside unit we are also going to mold inside of the car so it doesn't shake and fall or start to leak or anything like that. Yeah, but it should be soon ready. Yes, so it's done and we are ready to start the cooling. And I go through the setup. So everything starts from the generator. We have 2 kW of power. And I think I can start this now. Yeah, really cool and quiet. And then I can come down from here. Yes. And then it starts when you turn the generator on. The heat pump starts and yeah, this is the inside unit that is outside and this is now on heating mode. The target temperature is 30 and here is about 20 and I'm pretty sure that this can't deliver this, or if it does then we found the reason for the climate change, but I think this is a bit too small unit for that. And then we have hole on the roof and the pipes go in. And then here we have the outside unit. And I think this had something like 5 kW or something like that heating power, which is cooling power in this case. So it should get pretty cold pretty fast. we are going to switch to regular electricity. There is no need to stress the power generator for a couple hours. The heat pump needs 2 kilowatts and the generator outputs 2 kilowatts. So it's full power all the time. Now we just take short 2-hour break. And there is temperature meter inside of the car. And I'm pretty sure that we can go sub-zero degrees Celsius with this, so it should freeze. Yes, we had coffee break. And I think it has been now on like maybe 1 hour or a bit less. And it's already pretty cold. I have thermal camera. And actually the coldest parts, according to this, the back windows, minus nine. I'm not sure if this is completely right, but it's there is some like there is ice on top of the glass.
Oh man, cool.
Yeah, it's ice. It's really cold, and I have temperature meter inside the car, so let's check that. And I put some towels and overalls on top of the car to make it like better insulated. So I'm going to open this in and dun. It's like minus 13.
Oh.
It's really cold. Yeah, the overalls work really well. They block the heat coming in through the windshield. And the car is pretty cold. Pretty cold. I think it's like time to go drive.
Yeah.
Which one wants to go, Matti or Anni? I think people want to see Anni inside of the car.
Of course.
Okay.
I'm not from this channel. So.
Yeah. Yep, so we are putting overalls on, it's cold there. Oh. Yes, and now we are going to go for a drive. Everything is quite frozen. I put some water here. And now since we are using generator, we can drive the car. It's really cold.
Yeah.
And that is blowing straight to us. Yeah, the car starts.
Ooh.
Bit hard to see outside, the windows are frozen.
Yeah.
Because it feels like winter morning. Check the car. Everything is on ice. Check the gear selector. It's really cold here. Everything is frozen. But then it's total summer outside. This is one of the weirdest things that we have ever done. Let's go for a drive up here. And the sun is heating quite fast. All the windows are getting clear. But I'm pretty sure that even on the sunshine, we can keep this below zero. And I think I would need more on my neck. It's starting to get really cold. And look, my breathing. I'm not sure can you see the camera, but it's like mist. And the steering wheel, it's really cold, I would need gloves. This is the weirdest thing ever. And I have this off, so the warm air doesn't come from the outside, inside of here. I'm not sure what would happen if we would drive really fast, like on the highway, would the airflow heat up the car? But at least the airflow clears up the windows. Because all the water was outside of the windows, and it evaporates away on hot summer air pretty fast. And it's really cold here, it's like stupidly cold. Let's drive one more lap here so we can see the car from the outside. Hey Anni, what is your opinion? How well this worked?
I'm not sure, is this like a good result, but this is a really cold result.
Yeah, film our back. So it takes quite a lot of room. You cannot have any rear seat passengers. And one other problem, this is the same thing with this. Check what happens to our drinking water. It's really weird because outside there is summer, it's like 20 degrees today, it's really warm. Yeah, I think we can go now outside. Ooh, I think we have given enough. This feels like sauna.
Yeah.
I got used to the temperature inside there, and I was like on the winter mode, and now it's summer again. It's like
That's half great.
A year in 1 second. But yeah, the car was really cold, and I think this was good demonstration that the heat pumps work also in the winter. At least they were able to suck the heat out from the car to really cold temperatures. And if the car had better insulations, we would have been able to go even colder. Yeah, and Matti has YouTube channel just about heat pumps.
In Finnish.
Yeah.
Yes. And Lämpö Ykkönen also installs heat pumps, so if you don't want to sweat on the summer, there might be still some left if you are fast.
Yeah, if you are very fast.
Yeah. They are ending soon, demand is high. Yeah. And the big heat pump on our workshop, it has been working really well. Mm-hmm. The electricity savings, especially in the winter, on the day when we switched it on, we lost about 65% of our electricity bill. So it's really good upgrade if you are running direct electricity heater on your workshop.
Or oil.
Yeah, oil. Both. It's like better than both. And it took just one day to install. And I have also a link to that video in description and end screen. So if you are interested more about the installation part or want to see like bit more reasonable use case, go check that video. Yeah, but I think that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.